Ayanna Buchanan is the president of the Amite Chamber, and she joins us just after a great meeting here at Mike's Catfish. Now, we heard from the clerk of court, Gary Stanga, but the big news was none other than the governor himself coming back to Amite to speak to this organization in, what, about 6 weeks?
Yes. So September 27th, the governor, John Bel Edwards, will be coming and being our guest speaker at our luncheon at the Florida Parish Arena. The tickets are on sale. We're selling tables for $180 and individual tickets for $30. You guys, our governor is coming to his hometown, and it is such an exciting time. The Amite Chamber, we are proud to host this event, and we're expecting a great turnout. So the tables are selling fast. Please contact us to get your tickets.
Well, I'm sure he'll be very candid because he's a lame duck now. He's about finished with his 8 years in office, so no telling what he'll say.
Exactly. And I mean, better late than never, you know. It was about time that the governor came to his hometown and talked to the people here, get a personal interaction with them. And yeah, he is headed out of the office, but it's been a good run.
How much will admission be?
Admission, $30 again, individual tickets, and tables, $180. But we're not selling. If you don't get a table or an individual ticket, you won't be able to come.
So this is at the arena. How much seating will you have?
So 25 tables, and we're seating, I'm not sure if it's six to eight people per table. So pretty decent crowd.
And what a wonderful facility, too.
Right. We always get the opportunity to host our luncheons there. Nice place, nice atmosphere. So we wanted to do the same for the governor.
You know, it occurs to me, 8 years in office to have an Amite native as governor, we should do more than we have done to commemorate this.
Absolutely. And I've said the same thing. When the board brought this to one of our meetings, I was like, you guys, we need to get Governor John Bel Edwards before he gets out of office to one of our luncheons. We've gotten his wife. She always comes and supports our meetings, and we are so thankful for her. But I'm like, we need to get the governor here before he gets out of office so that we can have that personal connection and that personal interaction with him.
You're part of the effort that got a sign in Amite that says it's the home of Governor John Bel Edwards, which is great, but don't you think we ought to do more than that?
I think so. I think with him coming home, getting out of office after those 8 years, I think that we'll be able to do a little bit more, get a little bit more of ideas of what he would like. We don't want him to sound vain or anything, but we would like to commemorate that more. I remember a time when Amite, Louisiana was completely unknown. Whenever you go to New Orleans, Baton Rouge, you mention Amite, Louisiana, that's the home of the governor. Oh, that's the home of Devontae Smith. Everyone knows us now. So we do want to do more to recognize that and highlight that.
Fly, Eagles, fly.
Yeah, fly.
So, great presentation by Gary Stanga. He covered the waterfront, and the clerk included in that the new system in which you can register your name. If somebody messes with your property, tries to steal your identity, you'll get an alert right away.
Correct. And the Amite Chamber of Commerce, we always have different guests coming out giving the information. You guys, we are here to not only promote the businesses, but the overall economic development. We know that crime rates are up right now in every capacity, not just property theft, not just murders, violent crimes. You guys, we want to do our part to help the overall economy here and the economic health of our town. So that's why whenever we have the opportunity to bring someone here that's giving helpful information to the people of this community, we take full advantage of that opportunity.
What else do you want to share with us?
I want to share with you guys that our memberships at the Amite Chamber of Commerce are 50% off. So if you do want to become a member, it is not too late to join. You guys, we have so much going on. And again, I am Ayanna Buchanan, president of the Amite Chamber of Commerce and owner of the Duchess Tresses Boutique located in Amite, Louisiana, 1101 West Oak Street, Suite 3.
Well, Mayor Walter Daniels was on hand here at the Amite Chamber. Good news that coming up in about a month and a half, we'll have Governor John Bel Edwards back in Amite speaking to the chamber.
Yeah, Ken, that would be very nice. I'll be happy to see him.
What are we doing to commemorate 8 years in which Amite's own native son was governor? We have the sign, which is wonderful, but don't we need more than that?
I would think so, Ken. I'm getting with the council, and we're going to try to figure out what we can do to really let him know that we appreciate the job he's done for the state.
I'd like to see a museum or something.
Yeah, I agree, and that's one of the things that we have been looking at.
Well, in the meantime, great news, road construction in Amite, including the long-awaited. It's a shame that the late Mayor Buddy Bell passed away before he could see it because he tried for years. The extension of Mulberry Street.
Yes, Ken. What's going on now? They're doing the water lines too, the extension of Mulberry Street, and when they finish that, then they're gonna do another water line on Rose Drive going around to Oak Forest. So that should happen. They're working on that, so that should be finished pretty soon. And once that happens, then we're gonna go out on bid to do this, the road.
When all this is said and done, will there be then two one-ways in Amite, like Thomas and Morris Street in Hammond?
Well, we still got to work on some things, you know, coming in from the east on 16. We got to figure out what we're going to do there to make that happen.
But that's the ultimate goal?
Yes, the ultimate goal.
And, you know, coming in from Franklinton to go to Walmart, there's just an amazing amount of traffic from the east.
Right, and that would help alleviate some of that traffic, because during the lunch hour or during an afternoon, we have a lot of traffic flow. Even during when everybody's not taking lunch or going home, we still have a lot of traffic flow in Amite. So we have to do something to alleviate it.
It's a good problem to have, isn't it?
Oh, yes. It keeps us going. It helps us out a lot.
And keep sales tax receipts up.
That's right. It does. So we happy to see the traffic coming through Amite like it is. So we looking for an expansion. We're going to probably in the near future annex some areas in that's going to help us out just expanding Amite.
Residential or commercial?
It's going to be both, residential and commercial.
So how are your sales tax receipts holding out?
It's been holding up pretty good, you know, and I got to give thanks to the citizens of Amite and the surrounding areas. We've really been doing good.
What other road projects can we look forward to?
Well, Ken, you know, the state going to come in and they're going to do from the River Bridge all the way to Livingston Parish on 16. So that's going to be, that's in the near future also.
Well, that'd be tremendous. 16 is a great highway for Amite.
That's right. That's what we count on. And that's one of the projects that the governor helped us on. So we really appreciate what he do for us.
So how is the budget process coming? You're overdue in getting a budget.
Well, we last month we voted to pass the budget, so we're doing pretty good. You know, we're going to have to work out some other means of trying to get some sales tax in.
Still, you're wanting a deficit.
Well, not exactly this year, but probably next year it might be a small deficit, yes.
What else are you working on?
Basically, that's it, Ken. We're just trying to get our wastewater project going, and once we get that going, then that's going to be helping us for is getting some things done in Amite.
Now, that would be every municipality from Tickfaw North would join the Amite system.
If everything work out okay, yes.
I want to give a little credit because, you know, we know the governor, we know the state, it's a state project, but Parish President Robbie Miller also has been involved and has gotten zero credit for it.
No, we give him all the credit also, Ken. He's been very helpful in helping us get what we need.
And then, too, the Mulberry Street extension, that's a parish road project as well.
Yes, that is. You know, what happened on that, we basically, the juvenile office was the town of Amite City, and we kind of swapped it out for the road work. So it helped them and it helped us also.
Well, good for you. Thanks again for joining us.
Okay, thank you, Ken.
Riding in style is important to me, but so is having a reliable car. That's why I do business with Bill Hood Ford Lincoln. The Hood family has been around since 1929, tackling high car prices so you too can have a stylish and reliable car. I do business with these guys, and I can tell you the short drive is well worth it. A friendly staff and a huge selection of new and certified used cars and trucks means just one thing, super savings. I'm Cam Jordan, and when you drive a little, you'll save a lot at the Bill Hood Auto Group.
What precipitated us pursuing this was two things. I had read or saw a video too about the FBI saying that one of the fastest growing crimes in the country is property theft. And also due to the amount of advertisements on TV with different companies offering basically its insurance about property theft, I started getting contacted by some of my constituents about, you know, was there anything that we could do? I attended a meeting some time back with the clerk of court from Washington Parish and the clerk of court from St. Tammany Parish, Melissa Henry. And Melissa was working on a system in St. Tammany to alert her constituents in the event that somebody recorded any kind of document that would have a an effect on their property. So I got with her and we started working on it. Lance Anderson, raise your hand, Lance. Lance is my my IT guy. St. Tammany, they have a whole IT team. They have like five or six people that works on IT. Lance is my team. So we're a little bit more limited. But anyway, working with St. Tammany Parish, we were able to come up with this system, and we're providing it free of charge. And what it does, it's not a complete, in other words, it doesn't remove all of your problems, but somebody can come into the office today. And of course, these are all fraudulent documents because they forge signatures and stuff. But as clerk of court, if someone comes in with a document and everything's properly filled out, by law, we have to record it. And we don't question it because, let's face it, whatever the population is of Tangipahoa Parish, 150,000 or whatever, we don't know everybody in Tangipahoa Parish, and we don't know what business they're transacting. So if they come in with a properly executed document, have it filed, and an example is a quit claim deed, not quick. To me, it should be quick, but it's a quit claim deed, Q-U-I-T. And basically all it says is that Lance Anderson is transferring his property to me, to Gary Stanga. And once that document is recorded, then all of a sudden Lance owns my property. He can, at that time, Lance could go, he could make a loan against it, or in some cases, in other parishes, they have even people claim the property and then they try to sell it right out from underneath people, and it gets into a big hoorah. Anyway, what this system does, once you sign up for it, you will get, if anything is recorded today, I signed up, I was one of the first ones, and if anybody would come in and record something saying Gary Stanga on it, then tomorrow morning I would get a notification saying that something was recorded with my name. Now, even if Mark Colway goes into our office today and has something recorded, has his name on it, Mark, you're going to get a notification the next day, but you're going to know that you did something. So if you get a notification and you haven't done anything, then you need to call the office, find out, you know, what it was that was recorded. And at that time, what you're going to have to do is you're going to have to seek legal advice. You're going to have to get an attorney, and then the attorney will take the proper civil action, and probably in most cases there's also criminal action taken also. About 2 weeks ago, St. John the Baptist Parish. There was a gentleman arrested, he and his daughter, for 33 counts of property theft. There's been cases in Jefferson Parish, there's been cases in Orleans Parish, and I only know those because we have access to the news out of, you know, out of New Orleans. So you hear about those things. I'm sure there's other cases that are happening throughout the state and even throughout the country. We actually had a case, it was a little bit different, but it's still, if the people would have been signed up when this happened, they would have been notified. We had a case where a lady, and I use the term loosely when I say lady, but there was this woman that came from Georgia, moved down here, and we saw her, you know, I saw her in the office running in the books, you know, looking stuff up. It doesn't really, that doesn't ring any kind of alarm bell because we have people doing that all the time. So eventually she went to civil department and she filed a document that was making her executrix over an estate. It civil processed it, it goes to the judge signs it. So, you know, she was over that estate. Well, she would have probably done okay, but she came back and did it again. Well, the second time that she did it, the supervisor in my civil department got with me and let me know about it, and she was suspicious. I got to looking into it. When I look at the owners, I happen to know one of the ladies in that was one of the heirs in Hammond. So I called her and asked her, did she know this person? Was not, she didn't know her, had no kind of connection to her. So we referred it to the proper authorities and she got caught. And then the previous one, I'm sure those people had to take appropriate action to get her removed as executrix. Anyway, if you go on our website, tangyclerk.org, there is a button, there's several buttons, three buttons, and one of them has red on the bottom, and it says property fraud alert. You click on that button, and it's gonna take you through and allow, all you gotta do is put your name. Now, what you really needed to do is put every variation of your name that you can think of. For example, when I did mine, I did Gary Stanga, Gary T. Stanga, Gary Timothy Stanga, and that was basically it. But some people have even more variations than that. And when you get to women who are married, you know, a lot of them use their, my wife uses her middle name when she signs stuff, and her maiden name initial, she assigned Jean R. Stanga on some documents. So in some documents she has to sign Catherine Jean Stanga, but there was a lot more variations of her name than there was of mine. There is no limit to the amount or of names that you can put. Businesses can sign up. You know, you just have to put the
LLC,
yeah, and the name. If your name's associated with that LLC. So that's basically it on the property fraud alert system. It's very simple. All that you're putting is your name and your phone number. And no matter how many pieces of property you have, any one of them that would, that somebody would try to do something with, you, it would be covered, because everything that's in our system goes by name, not the property description. It's not, you don't have to describe every piece of property, in other words. Just put your name in any piece of property that you have, in, that anyone would try to record something on, you'd be notified. Pretty much everything in a clerk of court's office is public information, with the exception of juvenile matters and adoptions. And some, even some criminal cases, if they're sealed, then it wouldn't be public record. But other than that, everything's, anybody can come in and just ask for it. Happens every day. I just want to mention, you know, in the last 6 years, we have done a whole lot of stuff in our office as far as bringing Tanspo Parish Clerk's Office up to into the 21st century. A lot of it, Lance was really responsible for getting all the, you know, everything working. But we have, you know, our, we have subscriptions that attorneys or real estate people, banks, whoever, can subscribe to, and they can, they can go in mortgage and conveyance and you know, look at stuff. I think we have it, the last time I checked, it was 1950 or 51. We had it back scanned too, and we're continuing to back scan. My goal is to have 100 years. Attorneys can file lawsuits and stuff from the convenience of their desk. And I'm gonna tell you why this is important to you, even though you may not be an attorney. Attorneys charge by the hour. If an, if you have an attorney in Hammond and he's gonna file a suit, once he gets the suit ready, he has to drive from Hammond to Amite, 30 minutes, right? And then when he gets to the courthouse, does his business, let's say it takes him another 30 minutes, and then he's got to drive back to Hammond another 30 minutes. So billable time at $250 an hour or $300 an hour, whatever the going rate is. If it's 300, that's $450 that it costs you for him to drive from Hammond to Amite to file that suit. Whereas now, once he gets the suit prepared, he can hit a button and it transmits the suit directly to us, and it goes in a queue. Those suits get handled very timely. Because of this new system we have, this, the suits, whether it's a walk-up suit or whether it's somebody that does it electronically, they go from the front counter to the second group of people that review it and put any other information in, then to the third group who go back and review the entire thing to make sure it's correct. And then once that happens, it's sent electronically again to the judge. The judge has it in their computer in their office. So they can, when they go in their office, if they get out of court, they can go back in their office and they pull it up, boom, they can electronically sign it, send it back to us electronically. We can issue whatever notices or whatever we have to do with that particular suit. And it's all done, bam, bam, bam. You know, it's really, just dramatically increased the speed at which all, everything, all the documents are handled in our office. Also, we have criminal records that are online. And there's, these are separate subscriptions. There's one for property, one for civil, and a separate one for criminal. And because not everybody needs all of it, okay? And quite frankly, we didn't want to provide all of the access to just everybody, because then you got, there was a case in St. Tammany where some kids, when I say kids, teenagers, high school students, went in and because their one of their parents had access to the records, and they went in and they dug up some dirt basically on the teacher and then blasted it all over social media. Our Secretary of State, Kyle Ordoin, one of the reasons I think he stepped down was all of the hoopla and over the method of to vote. I can tell you that every clerk of court in the state of Louisiana is in favor of continuing to use an electronic machine. It's possible that we can get an electronic machine that also, and for lack of a better word, I'm gonna say it would print a receipt to show you who you voted for. I don't think that's necessary, but if people want it, that's fine. Because let's face it, if someone could rig a machine, then they could rig the machine to not only change your vote, but they could rig the machine to print out whatever. I can tell you this, I vehemently opposed any thought of going to a strictly a paper ballot. If you think that, or if there was ever any fraud with the old stuff, you get paper ballots, and you're gonna have, they had this group in Louisiana, and they were big proponents of paper ballots, and not only paper ballots, but they wanted them all hand counted at the precinct that night. Can you even imagine how long that would take? We would be days trying to figure out who won an election.
According to the Caring Communities Youth Survey, Tangipahoa is one of the 10 parishes in Louisiana with the most underage alcohol use. We as a community want to take a stance and protect our youth.
I'm Robbie Miller, Tangipahoa Parish President, and 21 means 21.
I'm Summer Smith with Tangipahoa Parish SAD. Underage alcohol use is not a minor problem.
Our library is here for you. I'm Tangipahoa Parish Library Director Barry Bradford, inviting you to join us for the 2023 Summer Reading Program. There'll be fun, prizes, special performers, and of course, plenty of exciting books to read. Go to tangilibrary.com to sign up and see our schedule, and I'll see you this summer at the library.
Team Tangipahoa needs your help. This year, Tangipahoa will be updating our comprehensive plan. Our current version was adopted in 2008, and we want to update this plan, which will guide the future of our parish for many years to come. We can only do this with your help. The plan needs to reflect our needs, goals, and values of all of our citizens. And you can help by sharing what you love and what you'd like to change, and the ideas for our future. You can do this by completing the survey at tangi2045.com. That's tangi2045.com. And we're also going to have in-person sessions for you to give us your input. For more information, please go to tangi2045.com and help us keep Tangipahoa the best parish in the state.